considering marriage.
Miss Claudine, I just want to say that I think you're a splendid woman, and I'm sure our paths will cross again. And, well, I'd consider it a great honor if you'd allow me to kiss you goodbye.
Howdy, Jeff, huh?
And a great big howdy to you. This girl is the cousin you've been telling me about?
Yeah, Jasper. She's the one we'll be staying with in California.
Well, poke me another air hole, baby, and let's go.
Oh, good morning, G.
Morning.
The personal touch is very important to these people, and they are the bank's largest depositors. I'd be happy to volunteer my car and myself. I could take at least half the load. Jethro. And the luggage. See, Chief.
Unknown.
Entendu? Mon capitaine.
Well, they appear to be hillbillies.
Is anything wrong with them?
Oh, no. You see, we served lunch before we arrived, and they refused to leave the plane until they helped do the dishes. And we served 120 lunches. Well, here they come.
Flight 201 for Chicago and New York is now loading at the East Condor.
Oh, thank you for sharing your food with us. Thank you for doing the dishes. You sure you don't want us to wash the windows? It won't take long if we all pit in.
Right there, howdy. Welcome home, it's Tappy. This here is my cousin, Pearl
Booty. Oh, howdy, Mr. Jarrett. Oh, excuse my wet hair.
Oh, it's quite all right. Well, how did you enjoy your plane ride?
I don't believe it. A plane, don't believe it. It's a miracle.
Oh, well, ain't that gypsy cam.
Got some food there? Well, I can't stay long, but I am kind of hungry. Wash all them dishes. Give me quite an appetite.
Yes, them stairs is moving. I'm in a California earthquake.
Pearl, them stairs are supposed to move like that.
What's that?
I don't know, but that's what they call an escalator. The only thing is, last time we was here, they was moving the other way. Come on.
Well, we ain't gonna get on them crazy stairs.
Oh, come on, Pearl. Once you're on there, you like it. No.
Rooms in this house, or something tells me it ain't gonna be big enough. the same way, Jetrine. Drysdale, if I got enough money to take everybody out to a nice eating place, Mr. Clampett, with your money, you can buy the finest restaurant in Beverly Hill.
Before the battle's over, that's just what I might have to do. Come on.
Gonna listen to a story about a man named Shed. A poor mountaineer barely kept his family fed. And then one day he was shooting at some food, and up to the ground come a buffalo. Oh, that is black gold. Billionaire, and folks said, Jed, move away from there. Said, California is the place you ought to be. So they loaded up the truck and they moved to Beverly Hills, that is. Slimming homes, glory stars. The Beverly Hillbilly.
Sleep. And you was liking it too, Granny. You kept asking for another slug of soup.
That's because I couldn't believe that Pearl could make such good soup.
Hey! What are you doing up? You don't have to took care of when it gets to be your age.
My age? Well, I'm in the prime of life. You tell your Aunt Pearl that. Never mind, I'll tell her myself.
Don't get riled up at Pearl. I reckon she's just trying to be helpful.
She's about as helpful as an alligator in a swimming hole.
I'd rather be caught twixt a pair of scrapping bobcats than two women trying to run the same house.
Granny, I'm enough to get out of bed.
Jeffrey, you take that back outside. And while you're at it, you fix some flowers for your ma's sick room.
Ma ain't sick.
She ain't been up with me yet. Where is she?
In the kitchen doing the ironing.
Ironing? I ain't done the washing yet.
More than that, while you were still in bed.
All by herself?
Oh, no. She had all of us helping. Ma gets a kick out of running things.
She's gonna get a kick that she ain't looking for. I wanna boot her so hard that every time she snoops, I don't gadget. Work around here is just plain. Where you going with that, Jeffrey?
Outside.
I told you to take it up to Granny's bedroom.
Granny told me to take it outside.
You're taking your orders from me and not from Granny. I get to be her age, that somebody will be looking after me. You can quit hoping and praying. And if you keep messing around my kitchen, you ain't gonna get to be my age. Don't stand there. Do as Granny says. Take it outside. How do you feel, Granny? Did you sleep off the soup? I mean, did the soup help you to sleep? Now you listen to me, Pearl, and you listen to the whole thing.
Did you to wash the whole outside the house?
Yes, sir. She said every inch of it.
Well, if she ain't the cleanest woman. Come on, I'll help you.
Granny!
Running off and leaving a child that sick. She sees every morning when she looks in the mirror.
I was talk if I were you. Stop it, Pop. Yummy comes a truck and there's nobody a driving it.
You're gonna be sorry you said them things when Jeff Green commences singing with a big orchestra like Rudy Valley. Rudy Valley and his Connecticut Yankees. Did you hear that, Jen? Your traitor cousin Pearl is letting her daughter desert to the Yankees.
There you are, Pop.
Thank you, Lemmy.
Well, that was friendly.
We'll see something nice and friendly about.